Hey, good morning. It's Uncle Lou here. Yeah, that's right. It's me, Uncle Lou, live for you on YouTube again today. Thanks for watching. I really appreciate it. Another preview video up today, getting close to the season, less than 60 days away. I'm doing a whole string of team-by-team preview videos. I'm putting them in a playlist so you guys can keep up with it. I'll put the link right up here somewhere right now. If you've missed any of the previous previews and you want to check them out, you can click that link and it'll take you right to it. Up today, a request from Alan V. and Robert T. from over on the Uncle Lou Patreon page. The first link in the description of the video will take you to the Uncle Lou Patreon page. Become a member of the Patreon page. I'll do any two team previews that you want me to do. I'm going to do these Patreon previews first, then I'm going to do whatever's left that I want to do. Then I will take suggestions from the comment section here on YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter. So let's jump right into it today with the third team preview for the 2018 college football season. Let's go! Last season for the Clemson Tigers, 2017. 11-1 in the regular season. Unexplainable loss on the road at Syracuse. Obviously lost to a fruit. You had to. You win your division at 11-1, obliterate Miami in the ACC championship game. Then you wait 30 days to get run off the field by Alabama in the first round of the playoffs. So another great year for Clemson. What was that, the third year in a row? I believe it was making the playoffs. Lost to Bama in the championship game in 15. Won the championship game against Bama in 16. Lost in the first round against Bama last year. Who do they have coming back? Who did they lose? Well, their defensive line last year was full of NFL juniors, so they're all gone to the NFL, right? Wrong! All these jokers returned. It's almost unfair. Clemson's defensive line, tackles and defensive ends, is bordering on unfair at this point. Probably the best defensive line in college football. There's a few other teams with elite defensive lines, but it's hard to find another one that can stack up to Clemson's. Loaded with talent at the linebacker position for this year. If you're looking for a weakness on Clemson's defense, there's really not one. They're a little thin and inexperienced in the secondary. I think they lost seven starters off the defense from last year. I think they lost seven starters off both sides of the ball, actually, but back to the defense. A little thin and a little inexperienced in the secondary. So, I mean, it's hard to call. I mean, they got talent there. It's hard to call that a weakness, but I guess we can call it the least talented of the three layers of Clemson's defense, I guess, would be their secondary. Offensively, great running backs with Feaster and Eddie, is that his name? Couple of holes to fill on the offensive line. They lost, I think they lost, was it both their guards? They lost two starters. I know they lost off the offensive line. Loaded at receiver. I think T. Higgins has a chance to break out this year as one of the best wide receivers in all of college football. Saw limited action last year. Explosive playmaker, could take the lid off of a defense. Unbelievable athlete. And of course, Hunter Renfro, sort of a prototypical possession receiver, great third down receiver, slot receiver, that type of thing. Quarterback, question marks, but a lot of talent. Of course, Kelly Bryant played last year. I've been hard on Kelly Bryant. You know, I think most people would agree Kelly Bryant probably played a little bit better, actually, than what a lot of people maybe thought heading into last year. The issue with Kelly Bryant, I think, he has a low ceiling relative to some of the other elite quarterbacks in college football. Now, he can run around, and he's an elite playmaker when he takes off running. He struggles some putting the ball down the field. It's hard to deny that. Is he a terrible quarterback? No. Is he Jalen Hurts bad? No, he's, you know, hardly anybody's that bad. But he does struggle a little bit putting the ball down the field. And I've said this a lot during the offseason. I said it leading up to the Clemson-Alabama playoff game last year. I just don't think Clemson can get where they want to go with Kelly Bryant at quarterback. So in comes Trevor Lawrence, very highly recruited freshman out of the state of Georgia. One of the most college-ready quarterbacks I've ever seen on film or tape or highlights, whatever. If you've seen highlights or film or seen this kid play in high school or at any of these camps that he's participated in, it's absolutely unbelievable what this kid can do. He can throw the ball 70 yards from his knees. He's 6'6". Does he give you the running ability that you get with a Kelly Bryant? Not really, but he's surprisingly mobile for somebody that big. And when he runs, he has deceptive speed when he runs. Now, he's not a running quarterback, so don't be all up in the comment section telling me what an idiot I am. I know he's not a running quarterback, but he's not Jacob Eason either, right? Jacob Eason, another guy, 6'6", arm like a cannon, but the dude's got his feet are stuck in cinder blocks, right? The dude just can't move. Trevor Lawrence can move around when he needs to. He doesn't look like he's running very fast, and he's not going to be the fastest player on the field or anything like that, but the guy's 6'6". Every time he takes a step, that's 3.5 yards gone. So deceptive speed there, but this guy has all-world ability. I mean, he's got first-round NFL pick written all over him. I've been saying this all offseason. If you've been following along, I'm of the opinion Clemson should just play Trevor Lawrence from game one on. We'll see if that ends up happening or not. Have a feeling. You'll probably see both those guys play, Kelly Bryant and Trevor Lawrence, here week one. We'll talk about that when we get into the schedule. The issue Clemson's going to have is, I guess, if they play Trevor Lawrence, what does Kelly Bryant do? Because Clemson has lost to transfer some highly ranked quarterbacks that they had. Hunter Johnson, was that his name? He dipped out, which tells me he was already behind Trevor, or Trevor Lawrence was already ahead of him on the depth chart. He saw the writing on the wall and he got out. So depth could be an issue for Clemson at quarterback should something happen with one of those two guys, Bryant or Lawrence. But Clemson is absolutely loaded on both sides of the ball. They've won the ACC and made the playoffs the last 2 years. I'm going to go through the schedule game by game. It's hard to see a reason that Clemson doesn't repeat as ACC champs and a representative in the college football playoff for 2018. Let's take a look back like we did in all the other preview videos. Let's take a look back real quick here at what I said during last offseason heading into the 2017 season about Clemson's chances for last year. Let's take a look.
Yabba dabba dabba! You lost to a fruit!
All right, I'm just kidding. Obviously, that wasn't last offseason's preview video. That was the clip of me laughing at the Taters losing to a fruit. Believe it or not, I went back and looked. I did not make a Clemson preview last offseason. I did an ACC preview where I previewed the entire conference, but I didn't do a team-by-team. I did a lot of team-by-team previews, but I guess no one must have requested Clemson or either I got too busy and just didn't do it. I'm a very busy and important person. So it's possible that I just didn't get around to it. But anyway, let's jump into this year's schedule and see what it looks like. Week one at home, Furman. This isn't even fair. The score is going to be whatever Dabo Swinney and the coaching staff at Clemson want it to be. You're going to absolutely run over this team. It feels kind of weird saying this about a team as good as Clemson. I think this is a good year for Clemson to start off with one of these teams, though. They played Auburn early in the season. Actually, that might have been week two. Anyway, it doesn't matter. Point is, I think it's good for Clemson this year to start out with a team like a Furman because of the situation at quarterback. This is a prime opportunity here to get Trevor Lawrence into a game in Tiger Stadium, if that's what you even call it. I don't know. Or is it Clemson Memorial Stadium? I don't know. Death Valley. Yeah, that is cute, too, when they run down the hill and release the purple balloons. But so Furman, great opportunity to get Trevor Lawrence some experience here, see what he can do in an actual college game, right? But you're going to blow them out. That's an automatic win, obviously. Week two at Texas A&M. I guess you're going to have the quarterback situation figured out for this one. It's on the road against Dabo's old nemesis, Jimbo Fisher. Now, Dabo got the better of Jimbo the last couple of years in the ACC. Jimbo got the better of Dabo prior to that. Now, of course, Jimbo leaves the ACC in Florida State, takes up residence at College Station, head coach, Texas A&M. Win. I'm sorry. I could have done a toss-up here just to, like, you know, draw it out, make it dramatic, build suspense, whatever. Clemson's winning this game. I'm sorry. I'm an SEC homer. I'll be pulling for Texas A&M here. Nothing against you, Clemson. Everyone knows I'm an SEC homer. But just give me a break. Tell me this. Who's more talented, Florida State or Texas A&M? If you answer Texas A&M, slap yourself in the back of the neck. No, Florida State's more talented. Jimbo Fisher is downgrading. Now, eventually he may get Texas A&M to the point where they're at a Florida State level of talent or even Clemson or whatever, but it's not right now. I don't see any way Texas A&M wins this game. I'm not even going to do it a toss-up. I'm just going ahead and giving you a win there. You start out 2-0. Week three, you play Georgia Southern, another who-cares game. If for some reason you don't have your quarterback situation figured out after you beat Texas A&M, this gives you one more week to get it straightened out before you start your conference play, but you beat Georgia Southern home without a problem. All right, on the road at Georgia Tech. I gave you a win there. You're way more talented than them. They run that tricky offense, but you face it enough where it shouldn't be a problem. But defensive coordinator, what's his name? Venables, whatever. Shouldn't be hard to figure out what's going on. I look for you guys to shut that down. Georgia Tech, I don't think, will be a very good team again this year. Shocker, I know. Let's see. That puts you 4-0, right? 1, 2, 3, 4. Yep. All right, on the road. No, at home, I'm sorry. To Syracuse. Toss-up. I'm just kidding. Win. You're a way better team than Syracuse. You're a better team than them last year. This brings me to a quick point I want to make here. It's very hard to go undefeated. I mean, very, very hard. How many times has Alabama gone undefeated under Nick Saban in this magical run they're on or whatever? One time. It's very hard to go undefeated. So, you lost to Syracuse last year, and I give you a hard time about it. A lot of people do. You lost to Pitt the year before that. I gave you a hard time. A lot of people did. It's hard to go undefeated. So there's no shame in being 11-1. You'll beat Syracuse on the road at Wake Forest. A win. The point is you're going to lose one of these games on this schedule. I might have them all as wins here, but you, chances are you'll lose one. Could be if I had to pick one, maybe Georgia Tech. I don't Texas A&M. I don't know. Anyway, at Wake Forest. Wake Forest is an improved team. Not as bad as some Wake Forest teams we've seen. Not as good as some of the best Wake Forest teams we've seen. But above average for a Wake Forest team. Still, I think you go and take care of business here at Wake Forest and win this game pretty big. That takes you into your bye week. Coming out of that, you get NC State at home. Last year was NC State's year, wasn't it? They should have took advantage last year, shouldn't they? But they didn't. They lose too much. They had one of the best players in all of college football last year in Bradley Chubb. He's gone. I think you beat NC State. All right. On the road, FSU, toss up. I can't just mark them all wins. What's the point of doing a video in that? FSU's a toss up game. I will come back at the end of this video and pick a winner on it, but you have to play them there. Let's be real. Florida State had a bad year last year. What ended 7-6, whatever they were. They're talent-wise, they ain't a 7-win team. Okay, they're a 9-10 win team minimum, just based off talent alone. Jimbo had one foot out the door last year. It was just a disaster in a whole lot of ways. Quarterback issues, which they still haven't figured out what they're going to do. They may not have it figured out even by the time you play them halfway through next season. Who knows? I don't like their coach. I'll tell you that now. I don't like that Taggart and Baggart. Willie Taggart and Bagger, whatever his name is. So I'm going to put that as a toss-up for now. I'll come back at the end. All right, home against Louisville. Different verse, same as the first from NC State. If Louisville was going to do something, they should have done it the last couple of years when they had Lamar Jackson. You can't tell me Louisville is going to do more now that they don't have Lamar Jackson than they did when they did have Lamar Jackson. Sorry. Ain't happening. You'll beat Louisville without a problem. You beat them with Lamar Jackson. You'll beat them without. At Boston College, another team a little bit better than a lot of people think they are. Still, you should win this game. This is around the time of the season last year, though, when you went on the road and lost to Syracuse. So don't let your guard down. Anytime you got to play one of these games on the road, I mean, this is why they play the game. Anything can happen. So I got you as a win there, but maybe keep an eye on it. Finished the season with three home games. Duke and South Carolina. You'll win both those games. I'm tired of picking South Carolina. When I do my week-by-week videos during the season where I pick out like five or six interesting games or whatever that are coming up on the weekend and I go through them in depth, I always try to pick one or two upsets because it is, you know, it's no fun to pick winners all the time or favorites all the time. I picked South Carolina to beat you Taters last year in the regular season finale, and you guys came out and beat them by 128 points or something like that. So there's a few things that Uncle Lou is never doing again until I'm wrong. One of those things is I'm never picking South Carolina to beat Clemson again until I'm wrong. So Taters, that's a win for you. Obviously, Duke, you should handle business there. Cutcliffe's a good coach, let's be real, but he's kind of like Franklin at Vanderbilt. You're only going to get Duke to a certain level. You're not going above that. And whatever that level is not high enough to beat a Clemson. So Clemson, you'll win that game. So that's 11 guaranteed wins and one toss-up, Florida State. I think you win. So I have you at 12-0. To me, if there's one team in all of college football this year that I would be the most shocked that didn't make the playoff, it's Clemson. To me, Clemson is the easiest team to pick to make a playoff. You should run through this schedule with no more than one loss. You should be in Charlotte for the ACC championship game. You should win it no matter who you play from the other side, and you should find yourself in January in another, your fourth straight playoff. They're obviously, there's favorites in every conference, right? Alabama in the SEC, Ohio State in the Big Ten, Oklahoma in the Big 12, Washington in the Pac-12. There's favorites everywhere. There is no bigger favorite to me within a conference to win that conference than there is Clemson. If anybody other than Clemson wins the ACC, to me that will be more shocking than any other team not winning some other conference. You shouldn't have a problem. I picked you 12-0 here. Wouldn't surprise me to see you go 11-1, though, not because you're bad or because I think any one particular team can beat you here. It's just, like I said, very, very hard to go undefeated. But I gave you 12 wins. We'll see. But you'll be in Charlotte, I'm sure of that. Anyway, that's it for today's video. I really appreciate everybody watching. If you're a Clemson fan and you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. I'm trying to get to 10,000 subscribers before the season starts. I know most people watching could care less how many subscribers I have, and it's not really that big of a deal. To be honest, it's just a goal I set for myself in January, and I'm pretty close to hitting that goal. I've got a little under 60 days, and I think I need 500 or 600 more subscribers to hit the 10,000 mark. So if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it somewhere, whether it's Facebook, Twitter, text the link to your neighbor, whatever it is you have to do. Send a smoke signal. Then the Oklahoma people can get it because they're engines. Anyway, let me get out of here. I'm ranting and just carrying on like a lunatic now. It's hot as the 11th circle of hell out here. Have a good morning.